wants to talk to him. Everyone does.
Everyone else is boring.
Stop showing boobs!
That's cheating. Judging by your wrists and your wits, your childhood was very happy.
Not really.
You seem to find coin pretty charming yourself. Clearly capitalizing on the political situation here.
And pretend you're after a gym to cure insomnia. Fortunately for you, I've determined your company a compensation payment now.
Do you doubt my capabilities?
No. Just your intentions. I said some things now. He's a...
a friend.
I'm not easily satisfied.
I'm beginning to like that. Really? What is it?
It's the sign from the CEO. You want the gym. But the M4 is broken. The gin's already long gone.
Oh.
The gin will fight you if you try and bend it to that scent. Lilac.
Gooseberries. Crafty thing in your head.
With a strong will.
Don't do that, Jennifer. Please. Play fair. Oh, fuck. You're ill. To help? Oh, you're a prisoner.
What did I do? Let's begin. Attack the pawnbroker in his shop, kicking him in the delicate places.
Nah.
I wouldn't be tempted if better prepared you for Yennefer. You're under a spell on here. I wish I was one who not.
Who is not? All of you,
I think perhaps you may understand.
Remember me? Didn't know you were a teacher. I've always wanted to play with one.
Just try. Boobs! Come on! She drew ovaries.
Express your deepest desires and you can be on your way.
Toss a coin to your witcher, oh valley of penis!
It's gonna be about Geralt, his last wish. What? You did that?
You're the one with the wishes.
Oh, that's interesting. What was his first wish?
I wish very badly to leave this place forever.
That's not gonna work. What are you gonna wish? Geralt, your final wish. What are you gonna wish? Is he gonna make a wrong wish for Yennefer?
She wants to be the vessel. Well, you
know this. I didn't understand that.
She wants to become more powerful.
Of course, I said it.
She'll die. Well, let's pray for her. On our way.
She thinks that she deserves better.
You're making me uncomfortable.
No. Do not tell me that this is finally the moment you've decided to actually care about someone other than yourself.
Save your life, yes, yeah. I can't let her die.
Be careful with your final wish.
I may help you.
You seem to want to be your end.
As do you.
No!
That's because I'm the one with the wishes.
Make your final one.
Coming the vessel for the gym, have you lose control? Not getting it! Can't you see what this is doing to you?
Fuck off! I'll do this myself!
Never, never! Tell me what you want!
I want everything!
Yennefer! He wants to help you! That's so not great! That's so bad!
You choose not to be a witcher! What do you deserve?
Yennefer, what is it? Are we not gonna know it? Hear it? It's free. disappeared. She's gonna be so mad at you.
She could not survive.
Yes, she did. She took a portal. That's great. She saved you. Yes.
I saved your life.
Both of you.
Did you also feel happy when you felt trapped? And if you were gonna pull us to safety, you could have taken us out of this shit town.
He's not dead. Nah! I'm sorry for you.
You're alive. Bollocks. I'm really alive.
Nah!
I was right about you.
What about his final wish?
My plan were.
There was no plan. What did you wish for?
Please.
Tell me. Geralt.
That's not a good thing for you, I think. I hope that we're gonna know. And quick!
Stop, please!
The false moss sack.
Your Highness.
What are you doing,
Sally? I've come to take you to your rightful place.
Sally has chosen to stay with us.
She should go to Geralt of Rivia.
She's been promised to him, for the low of surprise.
You know? How did you know?
He's the other edge of my destiny.
I don't have anything left to drink.
I need answers. And I need you. For my family too now, remember?
That's sweet.
Be vigilant. Always ask the right questions. Your destiny is in your own hands and no one else's.
You're taking him with you. I really hope that he's not gonna die because of that. You're gonna feel guilty if something is happening to him because of you. That was a great episode. That was a really great episode. It was not like the usual one, like during this first half of the season. Maybe a lot because of Geralt meeting Yennefer. That was so great. I was expecting them to meet because, like I said during my intro, you know, I was counting years and Yennefer working for that king during 3 decades, it meant that she was almost at the same period as Geralt. So I was right about that. They were really at the same time, like she took some years to work on her own, almost like that. And they just met. That's really interesting because they met and they like each other. That's interesting. That was really well done and well written. I buy it, you know, that's it. I'm not shipping them, not yet, but I love their chemistry, you know, how they are looking at each other. I think that it's really well working. A lot because of the actress who is playing Yennefer. For me, she's doing really an amazing job with this character since the beginning. And even with that kind of relationship, you know, with that kind of moments, she's playing so great. Okay, so Geralt was the one with the witches. I think that I need to see during the editing what was really the first wish. To understand what was it. The second wish, we saw it, and the third wish, we didn't hear it, we didn't see it. But after seeing it, the djinn left, disappeared, and Yennefer didn't have what she wanted to have. Geralt saved Yennefer with that moment. Yennefer saved him with the portal. They saved each other, that's great. They like each other, that's great. That can be good maybe for each other. I'm still wondering about that, if they can have really a relationship because they have strong opinions, you know, both of them, and a strong character, both of them, so I don't know if they can really match together, but that can be interesting to have them working together, at least being together for some times. We'll see if it can work or not. But Yennefer didn't have what she wanted, more powers and also ovaries, you know, to have a baby. So I think that she's not gonna give up on that. She's not gonna give up on having more powers, being more powerful and being able to have a baby. And I'm not sure that Geralt can help her with that or can agree with her for that. And that wish that Geralt did at the end, we didn't hear it, we didn't know it, but I'm pretty sure that maybe she's not gonna be happy about it, and maybe that's why she's gonna switch, you know, and go on the wrong path and become the villain character. That's my theory for her. For what I saw during the first half of the season, I really had the impression that she was gonna become a villain character. Now we know how she's connected, you know, with Geralt and the princess. Because now we know how she's connected with Geralt, but I'm still not sure, yes, of her destiny. That's it, really, we have to make a drinking game for all of the times that they are seeing destiny. Maybe not drinking, because I'm not drinking alcohol when I'm watching a show, but maybe something else, maybe I'm gonna find something else before the next episode, and you're gonna discover that during the next episode. The princess knows that she's connected with Geralt, that she has to find Geralt, and she knows that she's connected with him by the law of surprise. They just said it. She's gonna follow the wrong Mossack to go to the what? To the white light? To the white thing? What is it? Is it like a name for a country, an entity, a society, a weird society, a weird magic society? Or is it more like a religion thing? I'm still wondering about that. But she's following the wrong person, so what can happen to her? I'm not sure that something great can happen to her. Geralt and Yennefer, they're gonna work, be together for the next episode at least, if it's not more. I want them to be together for a long time because, like I said, I love their chemistry, but I'm really not sure that it can work their characters together, but also their ambitions and what they want. I'm not sure that it can work. Okay. That's great because we know now how they are connected to each other, all of them. We know now all of the different timelines and how to put them in a chronological order. But we are still missing stuff about why they are all searching for Ciri. Why, you know, this child, okay, she has powers because of her mother. Okay, she's connected with Geralt with the law of surprise. Is it just that? Is it something more than that? I really have this impression that it's more than that. Why do they all want to protect or to murder her? I'm still wondering about that. I'm wondering now about that relationship between Geralt and Yennefer, how it can evolve. And I'm still wondering about Yennefer. I'm still doubting that she's not gonna go on the wrong path. But see, my theory about all of this season being a prequel of the real adventure, which is gonna begin when the princess and Geralt are gonna meet. I'm doubting about that theory now because I have the impression that the two of them, you know, Geralt and Yennefer meeting during this episode, that was something really important. So maybe the adventure is beginning now, you know, now that they just met. I'm trying to read all of your comments and I'm responding to a lot of you, and I read that one of you was saying that the story of Ciri was not into that time during the books, you know, was not into the first book or books, and the first season is really made from the first book or books. I did not understand that, but you said to me that Ciri was not into that part of the books. So that's surprising, but also great that they are putting her into this season, this first season, because of the different timelines. If not, we wouldn't have seen her all along this season, you know, during this season. So I think that's great that they are making these different timelines for presenting us all of the characters, all of the different characters. And it's also interesting because it forces the viewers to think, you know, to really put everything, every scene into a chronological order and to think about how they can be connected to each other. I mean, for the ones who didn't read the books, for the ones who didn't play the games, I'm really a new viewer right there. I'm discovering all of this story, I'm discovering all of this world. So that's why at the beginning of my binge watching of this show, you were a lot to say to me that I was so dumb and so stupid to not understand it all just like that. But you have to understand that me, I'm discovering all of that. So for someone who is discovering a show without any information, without any, you know, details about a world, about the rules of a world and all of that, that's something different, you know, it's a different experience. So you have to understand what the show can be for people like me who are just discovering this world, this story, just like that, just with episodes, you know, with no backgrounds, no maps, no nothing really. I'm watching it without nothing, and I don't want to make any research yet for the show. I'm gonna wait the end of the season one because I don't want to have any spoilers about what can happen, you know, during the next episodes. Okay, I'm gonna finish this video right now because I'm not gonna post it today. You're gonna see that on next week now, but me, I'm gonna film that other video that I wanted to film today about that surprise that I'm making for you guys for February. Even if you are new, you know, into my channel because you subscribed it for the Witcher videos, you can participate, it's allowed. That's gonna be so great, I'm so happy about that. But I have to film that video now, I don't have a lot of time. So I'm gonna finish this review right now. It's all for today for the Witcher, for you and for me. So it's all for me for now, so bye for now, bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine?